welcome to 13th Sabbath. Glad you're here. We're gonna have an opening with a couple of songs. Sarah and Lola are going to do this with a couple of songs.
I'm being told that you need to use the mic. And then Scott will open with some superintendent remarks. And then we'll have a mission story, some local mission updates on what we've been doing here in our congregation, some updates from our Sabbath school classes so everybody gets to know what everybody else is doing. We'll have a special 13th Sabbath offering. And if we have time, and I think we'll have our mission video and then kind of a conclusion, get some input from all of you on what we might want to see in the next upcoming quarter. So with that, to Sarah, Savea, and Lola.
All right, good morning. We're gonna open our hymn books to 625, Higher Ground. Our next one is Ancient Words, and that is not in our hymnal, so we'll just have to read it from the screen.
In this world, there is sun with God's own heart. Oh, let the Good morning, everyone. Not sure if I should wear my glasses or not. Anyway, it's good to see you all. We've been gone for a few weeks. Yeah, good to see everyone. This is our 13th Sabbath offering, so it's kind of a high Sabbath this Sabbath. And so we're all meeting together for Sabbath school, which is kind of fun, isn't it? It is. Okay. So before we really begin our program, let's start with a word of prayer this morning. Heavenly Father, we are so grateful for your many blessings, Father, and how you have preserved us through the years, Lord. We pray this morning that you would teach us, bless us this morning, Father. I pray for each one that has a message today, Father, that we will have ears to hear and be blessed. I ask these things in your name. Amen. So, superintendent's remarks this morning. I just kind of jotted down a few thoughts, I guess. As we know, the adult lesson this last quarter was on the topic of Psalms. And so we are moving, of course, off of Psalms now after today. And we are looking at next. How many of you guys have quarterlies? I should ask you that next. Who all has quarterlies for this next quarter? So if you don't have one, I know Melvin and Dave were kind of getting the quarterlies out. So make sure you catch them to get your quarterly. And the new quarterlies are Great Controversy. And so it's probably going to be one of my favorites without even having read the quarterly yet. But that will be written by Mark Finley. So I really enjoy Mark Finley. And another plug for camp meeting. Mark Finley will be at camp meeting in Minnesota this year. So if you can make it to that. So that's what's going on in the adult quarterly study. Now, if we go back to this last quarter, or today's offering is actually our 13th Sabbath offering, goes towards Southern Asia Division. And so if you look on the back of your quarterly, it actually tells us where our offering for this quarter is going towards. And you'll see things such as a high school in India. There's a few different schools listed in India. I cannot pronounce the names, so I apologize. But as you go down the list, you'll see schools and churches, and they're helping out youth. They're building a youth training center in India. So there's several different projects that are going on with this offering. In fact, there's 10 various projects. So as you give today, it just gives us a little perspective as to where this money is going. It's going for much needed things. But Southern Asia, so we're looking at India, Nepal, Bhutan, that area. And I haven't even looked at where our offering is going for the next quarter. But anyway, let's start our program this morning. With that said, Sonia has our mission story.
Okay, well, I am super glad that Scott talked while the map was up there and showed where our offering is going for 13th Sabbath and where our focus is today, because I think Lauren and Isabel would both tell you that geography was never a strength in our homeschool program. But as we look at the map, we can see specifically where our offering goes today and where the mission focus is. And then I think Bobby will put up a picture next of a young man who our mission story today is about. And as I tell the story, I'll tell it as best I can to pronounce the names, but they're going to sound very American. So his name, fortunately, is Nathan. And I can handle that one. So Nathan grew up with missionary parents, a pastor father, and when he was 6 years old, his family returned to India, where they live, and they had been serving as missionaries in Lebanon. And so as a six-year-old, he really didn't have a missionary focus. But then as he started to get a little bit older, he started to have a heart for missions. And he says when he was 12 years old, he really felt that he wanted to become involved in missions. And part of that was because of his Sabbath school. And I was talking to Scott yesterday, and I said, you know, I'm really glad we're doing this and bringing up our youth and bringing up our young people, because I feel like missions is something that we really don't talk enough about, maybe as much as some of the generations who remember having more of a mission focus. I see some nodding. So I'm really glad we're doing this, because he said that focus in Sabbath school was something that really compelled him to want to take an active interest in a missionary focus. And I like his story today for a couple of reasons. One is because it does show us where our money is going. The school that he attends is one of the schools that was a dot on that map where our money is going today. But also the main reason I liked reading it personally was because his story gave me inspiration for things that we can all do. And he is a young teenager, and to me, this story that I'm about to tell you just really shares how at any age, we can be missionaries wherever we are. So when he was 12, he started to get that missionary focus, and he would look at his mission quarterly at Sabbath school, and he would think, you know, if God can use these other people, surely he can use me. And about the time he turned 15 is when the COVID pandemic hit. And just like us in India, they weren't able necessarily to attend in-person services for a time. And so his father, as a pastor, started doing some things online. And he put together a group for teenagers where the teenagers would meet virtually. And so this was all going very well. But they noticed that the younger children were also joining the group. So they had teenagers, but then they would have their younger siblings and other young people joining in. And one day Nathan heard his parents talking, and he heard them say, well, you know, we've really got two distinct groups listening in on this. We've got the older teens, and then we have the younger kids, and there's really nothing for those younger kids. And kind of a light bulb went off in Nathan's head, and he thought, this is my mission. This is something I can do. And what I really think is cool here is I've seen this same light bulb go off in our young people here. And we'll talk more about that as we go on today. But what he decided to do is, now remember, this is during COVID, and they're stuck at home. And so he went to his family's library, and he pulled off, you know, the classic Arthur Maxwell Bible stories. And he decided he was going to use those to do his ministry online to the younger children. And then he also, it was not this exact one. I think it was a book called like 28 Reasons God Loves You, but something that would really share the fundamental beliefs of the Adventist Church as well. And so he took those from his family's library, and he decided to use those in that ministry. And before long, they had even more young kids joining. So that was something that he could very well do. And so my thing that I'm really excited about is, and you'll hear more about this later, our young people said, we want to do something. We want to do something to minister to kids in our community. And later on, and I know they're kind of nervous about it, but later on you'll see a video that they made to share on our YouTube channel to do that. So it's really neat to see young people doing this. The second part of his story, this is again Nathan, he did this ministry online during COVID, and then he decided he wanted to do more. So he heard about another young person who was terminally ill and was praying for others and really had an active prayer ministry. And he thought, that's the other thing I can do. I can pray. I can pray actively for the kids in my class. And I think that is a message to all of us as well. We can actively pray for those we know. But the interesting part of his story is that he decided he was really going to zone in and focus on people that he thought had open hearts to the message, because he was in a school where not everyone was Christian. Some of the kids were there simply because the Adventist bus was the only bus that would pick them up. You know, it was the only school in their area they had resources for. So he noticed there were a few kids, he started praying for them, that he thought would be more open to the message of Christianity. And one of those was a boy named Aaron, and I'm sure that's not how you say it, but Aaron was really open, and he noticed him singing the Christian songs that they were singing, and he talked to Aaron about that, and Aaron said, yes, you know, I've accepted that Jesus is one of my gods. And so he thought, okay, well, you know, Aaron's heart is open. But also during the same time, there was another young man named Jai. And Jai was not open. And honestly, Nathan admitted that he wasn't even praying for Jai because he just saw that Jai's heart was really closed. And Jai came up to him and he said, you know, this isn't for me. And he would wear like war paint, you know, for his gods and his tribes to school. But one day, Nathan was playing the keyboard during worship time, and that really impressed Jai how skilled Nathan was. And so they got to talking about that, and eventually Jai said to Nathan, will you teach me the Lord's Prayer? And in this article, Nathan says, you know, he was really impressed that even the student he thought wasn't even on his prayer list, God could move in that heart. And I think that's a lesson for us too. We can pray, that can be our mission field as well. And we can pray because God can move mountains. And so as we give today, know that the funds we're giving are doing good works in India, in Asia, but also know that your personal mission is all the things we're doing. And I guess that's where my mission heart has always been locally, but it greatly inspires me to see people like Lola, who are also very mission-minded globally. So keep those things in mind as we move through our program. Next, we're going to have those local mission updates. And this is so super exciting. I love this part. I'm going to turn the mic over to some of the folks who can share what our local missions have been up to. So, namely, I have Jimmy and Lola, our personal ministries team's leaders. And then also I think Perry has something to share here coming up shortly, but I'll hand it over to Jimmy first.
Thank you. It is exciting to come and share with you what God is doing with this church in the community and outreach. And I was thinking as Sonia was speaking, remember a little part that she said at the end, that Nathan kind of had overlooked Jai. And it's the times that we overlook somebody is God says, you know what, don't. That's the person I need right there. And many times God will take that person and he'll be the one that is our next missionary, even though we may have turned that person away in our head thinking that's our decision. And I repeat this, if you want God to laugh, tell him your plans. because a lot of times it doesn't jive with his plans, so we need to pray that his will be done also. Wonderful that how that works out. And before I begin, I will just say that it seems, and I'm sure you will feel the same way, it seems that our adversary is hard at work every day that we go out into the world. somebody asked me this morning, how was your week? And it was, I had a good week, but it was a tough week. A couple tragedies. A friend of mine in Managa took his life, and another person was, their life was taken in a tragic car accident, coming home from their dad's funeral. And a 20-year-old girl now is not with us. But Satan is working constantly. And so what I'm going to say, it's the best times in this history that our church can shine and shine in the world with God's message. It's so needed now. And here's some of the exciting things that we will talk about. And it is exciting because I as I was putting this list together, I had to stop because there's more exciting things coming this year, but I couldn't keep going. But one of the first things that happened this spring was the youth got together and went and visited our local county law enforcement center. And being some of the people behind the scenes, I said, your jailers and dispatchers don't get to go out much. We can kind of come and go where we want in our squad cars, but those people do not get to go much. So I said, let's take some gifts to them. So the youth department took a Subway platter for everybody that works in the jail and dispatch. And they also called in the deputies off the road. I had feedback from a couple friends of mine where a deputy was at their house and they said, get over to the sheriff's department, there's food there. And I had gotten a couple texts from deputies that I know thanking us for what we did. So it meant well, and I think in the future, I talked to a friend of mine that's on the fire department in Wadena, and I said, what if our youth wants to do that? He said it would be very much appreciated. So I think that's one of your next goals, if I am thinking right. The next thing I will talk about is our blood drive. And I might have Lola come up here in just a second. But that was through Vitalant out of Fargo. And it took a while to plan that, to get organized, because this is the first time they had worked with an entity in the Wadena area. And it was some younger gals that we actually got to sit down and visit with and kind of share with about what the Adventist Church is. One of the girls had heard of it, but I shared with them that we have a health message because we feel that Jesus, when he was on earth, did more healing than he did preaching. And I said, so our church does that globally. So I said, we're honored to be part of this blood drive. And I'll just let Lola share a little bit.
So I got to have the privilege of organizing this blood drive that we did this spring. And it was really cool watching the numbers come in as you would talk to people. Every now and then you'd get another one added as I could check on the list. But I got a lot of members to come out and help us the day of. So thank you to anyone that did come and help with the registering and setting stuff up. And my mom brought snacks, so we were able to have some healthy snacks besides their chips and whatever. So that was good. And this fall, I believe we're planning on doing another blood drive, similar to what we did this spring. So anyone that would like to help out with that, keep in mind, I guess.
It was fun interacting with the people that came and visiting. I think we had allotted 37 spots. How many, do you remember, how many units? I think there was 22 or 25. Does somebody remember that number? I don't remember it right off, but they were really happy with the goal. A few of us gave double, which that means that they just take your blood cells. And that, if they do it at the blood drive, they don't have to do it later. So it takes a little longer. You may have a little bit more effect. For me, it didn't bother me. There was a couple people that had some effects. But when you know that giving blood is healthy for you as it regenerates, it helps your body. And really, there isn't much of a no when you give blood. People ask a lot of questions. Does diabetes, does, if I'm taking meds, does this? And usually the answer is, yep, come and give blood. You can still give blood no matter what, unless your doctor tells you specifically, you know, you don't. So it's really a cool program that the community uses. And best of all, they've seen the name Seventh-day Adventist and met people from that church helping with this, understanding that we are involved in health. So the next thing that I will bring up is singing at the Long Prairie Nursing Home. And I should have Daryl talk about this a little bit, but we had a wonderful view from standing up front, looking at the faces of the people listening to our singing. Daryl, do you want to share just a minute about that? I know this is spur of the moment. Thank you.
That's okay. I didn't have to worry about it ahead of time then, so I thank you for that. A few weeks ago, Perry, where'd that guy go? He was just right here. Anyway, Perry asked me, Daryl, would you like to expand our singing ministry? And inside I was thinking, no, I sure don't want to do that, Perry. No, not really interested. But of course I said, yeah, we could probably do that. So he said we'd like to see if we could sing at the nursing homes in Long Prairie and Clarissa, yes. So we did sing in Long Prairie last Sabbath, and there were 17 of us. I'm so proud of you guys for coming out. You know, we sounded, I thought, great. We were loud and we were good, I thought. I really did. What do you think, Sonia?
We sounded.
Yes, we did. There were 8 residents there to hear us sing and 1 worker, and one of the residents, her arm was up here praising the Lord the whole time. And another one was crying just about the whole time, and I don't think it was because the music was so bad. I think it was because the music was deeply touching her. Now, you went to talk with her a little bit toward the end. Am I right on that? She was being touched? Okay, I thought maybe there was something she was going through that was...
She was.
Okay, but...
But yeah, she appreciated it.
Yeah, yeah. I had to go out in the hall and blow my nose twice because I get all... These hymns, they... I can't even get to the second line of How Great Thou Art, and I'm a goner. I can't sing anymore. So I had to go blow my nose twice because the music was touching me so much. And there was one of the men, the residents there, talked with him briefly, and he was really enjoying the music and singing along. A lot of them were singing along with the songs. It was a huge success, I think. I had the time of my life. I would have had the time of my life if I could actually sing these songs from start to finish without bawling. But we enjoyed doing the singing, and they enjoyed having us there. And it just was a huge success, and we're looking forward to doing it the 4th Sabbath of every month there. Our first time there couldn't have gone any better. I have talked with the lady at the Clarissa Nursing Home. You're wishing you hadn't called me up here now, aren't you, Jimmy? And I've been waiting for her reply, but she hasn't replied yet, and so I will get in contact with her this week and find out if we can sing there. But Jim Johnson and Linda and the Judds and Tim Bennis are going to be singing there on Sunday, April 28th. So if any of you are interested in joining them, they would be happy to have you join. Augie said he's going to try and make it there that day. I might make it there that day. But you're invited Sunday the 28th. They're going to be singing there on Sundays, not on the Sabbath. So that doesn't work as well for us because we're all here on the Sabbath, so it works well for us to do it that day. But our first time in Long Prairie was a huge success. David? I don't. They may have told me, but I did not commit that to memory. So I'll give this back to Jimmy, and you'll think twice about having me. Okay?
Appreciate that.
Okay, you're welcome.
Thank you, Daryl. I think I can speak for everybody. 100% of the people that came from our church is looking forward to going back the second time because of what experience we had there the first time. And I think our staff, you haven't heard back from staff yet, but I think the staff really appreciated what they... I seen staff, and you probably did too, come out and was just listening in the back hallways to us from a distance. So that was pretty neat.
We need to bring extra hymnals next Sabbath. Yeah, there'll be more people next Sabbath.
Okay. That's yes, there's your answer. A note here that I have, Bible study has been rekindled and has started new once again, and the dates are
So right now we started doing Bible study every other Wednesday, every 2 weeks, and the next one is this coming week. But when we were at a personal ministries meeting the beginning of this year, there was an idea brought up to start a Bible study again, because the last time that we had did it was probably a few years ago when we had Pastor Roger around. And because we lost our pastor, we were studying Revelation. And because we lost our pastor, we just kind of, you know, we weren't so experienced with Revelation, so we weren't so sure that we wanted to do it by ourselves. So it kind of just fell off. And we never really started again. So now, We got it going again, and we've had two meetings so far. Our next is this coming week on the 6th, I believe, of April, and the topic is on reverence and respect. So if anyone would like to join, it's at 6 o'clock, I believe. April 3rd. It's at 6 o'clock, so please join. I guess.
There has been some great Bible studies already with our leaders, but yeah, Lola will be, and who else is helping you? Daryl. So don't miss the Bible studies. Coming up, Jamie George will be here the 10th. We're going to be advertising that. I dropped a note off with the chamber. So Daryl, I probably need to get you some information on that. That we need to get to the radio station. Cooking classes. Did everybody see the sign in the foyer? Cooking classes the 17th. Wonderful sign. Thank you, Lauren. And that is another exciting event for the public to come and learn, not just about cooking classes, but again, it puts a face to the name of the church that, you know what, we're interested in your health. It's just not a number or just come here on Sabbaths, but we want you to come and be healthy also, and we care about you. Toward the end of the month, or the end of the month, May 4th, I have a couple people coming. Dean, you'll understand this. I have a couple people coming that were former gangster disciples in Chicago. Ask your friends to attend this. This will be also in the newspaper. Sammy, that is going to come, was the governor on the west side of Chicago with the gangster disciples. And GD, correct me if I'm wrong, but that does not stand for growth and development.
It does.
At one time with Larry.
It stands for gangster.
Yeah. it's an enterprise, but not one that you want to be involved with. but I have been friends with Ron, and Ron helped Sammy get into the gangs many years ago in the 80s. I tried to talk to Sammy in 2000. He was on the streets. He was the governor of the gangster disciples on the west side. If you want to know gangs, go to Chicago. That's the leader. That's the growth of gangs. And when I wanted to talk to the governor then, he said, I'm not about that. A white cop from Minnesota looking to talk to somebody that's in an enterprise business making hundreds of thousands of dollars a day. And illegal activity. I wouldn't want to probably talk to a cop either. But he didn't know, and I didn't know, but within a year, the feds had put him into prison for life. From that moment, He spent 24 years, 22 years in prison, and life in the federal penitentiary is a death sentence. It's not like your local or state life, 30 years. And so Ron and I, at some point, talked about his sentence. President Trump got in office and did a restorative justice program across the nation, lowered his sentence to 30 years instead of life. And then I wrote a letter to Judge Palmer, the federal judge in Chicago, telling the judge I would like to use Sammy in my work. I feel that he is not going to go back to the gangs. When you're in your 50s, you can't run as fast. You can't duck as fast. You're not interested in that business anymore, correct? And so the judge heard my letter. I never intended for this, but it got into the Chicago Sun-Times. You can look it up on the internet. And she reduced his sentence another 5 years. That put him on the streets almost right then. He is coming to Wadena, Minnesota, and to where I work up in Park Rapids area, and him and Ron will be speaking and telling their story. And that is going to be in Wadena at the Maslowski Center, but I want our church to come and represent, and we'll be handing out Pathway to Peace and other forms of literature to lead people to Christ. And that's where we will shine at that point with these people. And I will say that Jesus hears, and sometimes the world feels that Jesus is distant. He doesn't hear us all the time. He looks down upon a world that's spinning, but he's not close to us. I know for a fact, pay attention to this, that the gentleman we have here today as a speaker, Dean Simmons, God reached down and touched your heart and brought him from a life that is not conducive for this church. He should never. And think about this as we move forward today, and I'll probably say this again up front, but there's no good reason that this gentleman right here should be sitting in church today other than a divine appointment by Christ. And that is a miracle. Thank you for coming today. So that is some exciting things for just the next month. We have a lot of things that I could go on, but you're not taking notes. You probably won't remember, but just remember, come and be part of this organization, because it's going to be exciting as we move on into the future this year. Just it's going to be crazy exciting. Scott, do you have anything at this point? Or?
Sabbath, is what you're saying?
Yes.
No.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, the Voice of Prophecy.
Yeah. How many years? I think there's 71, somewhere in there.
That's awesome. Yeah.
71 Bible studies through Voice of Prophecy with this church that have been directed, and that there's people, and I don't know everybody that's sharing, helping with that, but I know we have a few church members that are sending back the Bible studies, the correspondence back and forth, on the 71. So there's a fire that's been lit. Six or eight people of the church that's helping. So we've ignited a fire.
Awesome. All right, and I think Perry wanted to briefly share something here on local ministry.
Good morning, happy Sabbath. So I want to share a little bit about what we are doing as for the young adults. This quarter we were studying mostly Kings, and if you ever read through Kings, there's a lot of kind of history there. A lot of kings that followed God's leading, and then there was some that definitely did not. We also got into Elijah. And how God used him, Just wanted to share a couple verses that the people in our class kind of picked out that they got out of this lesson that they really enjoyed. Mine was from Job 22, 26, and 27. It says, "And you will find happiness by worshiping him. God will answer your prayers, and you will keep the promises you made to him." There's a couple others. One of them is in Ephesians 6, verse 10. I would have to look that up quick. That says, "Finally be strong in the Lord and his almighty power." So that was just some of the verses that our young adults, and we have anywhere from 4 to 6 every week. Another one was from John 16:33. "These things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. And the world you will have tribulations, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world." And so that's just some great verses that we've been studying this quarter and stuff. I believe Bobby might have a song here that we are also going to play at this time that we've been playing in our Sabbath school, and it just listen to the words, and it's meant a lot to us in our class.
All the things that I've held dear, the vanities that whispered in my ear, what would I do if they all disappeared? My soul's a prize. I don't wanna love what the world loves. I don't wanna chase what the world does. I only want you. I only want you. First things first, I seek your will, not my own. Surrender all my wants to you.
It's a great song. Thanks, Perry, for that. And then also just, I think most of you know, but it is Jimmy and Perry and Dave and Daryl lead out in that youth young adult class. And then we'll get updates here too from our other classes. So I'd like to ask Sarah and Lauren to come on up. And they'll share just a little bit about what they've been doing in cradle role in kindergarten. And I think Bobby's gonna bring up a few pictures for you to look at. So I'll pass this to Sarah.
Okay, well, in the cradle role class, we have three students currently. Addison, here down the aisle, and Ellie. And then we have Samuel, and they are so much fun. I am truly blessed to be serving as the Cradle Role teacher. It is so much fun. Oh, we got some pictures up there. That's your room. I think we got some pictures of Addison in class up there from last week. So this quarter we're, yep, there she is. And we do a lot of singing, although right now the students that I have don't sing and talk right now, but as they get a little bit older, they will be. We do little activities. So our lesson this quarterly right now is from this book here, and it's on Jesus being a little helper. And we talk and we sing all about how Jesus helped his mom and dad, and how he wants us to be kind and loving to others, and how we can be an example. And it is absolutely, if you've never been down there with your child or grandchild, come anytime and sit in. We'd be happy to have you. It is so much fun, and it is absolutely amazing to see how quick they catch on to the program. So we do the same program every Sabbath for the whole quarter. You know, that would be quite, I'm sure, boring for all of us. But with this age, we do the same thing the whole entire, every week. And they, even Addison and Ellie being as small as they are, within, for each program, within a few weeks, they know the whole program. I mean, they almost do it sometimes before I get out whatever I'm bringing out. You know, if I'm getting out bells or if I'm getting out felts or whatever it is, it's just really neat. So you can see Jesus in them, and you can see that they love Jesus all the time. So I am thankful to be serving in that department.
My name's Lauren. I teach the kindergarten class downstairs, and none of my students are here today, but if they were, they would say that their favorite part of class is craft time. We do a lot of crafts. Ours is similar to Cradle Role. We do the same lesson for about 4 or 5 weeks before we move on. I shouldn't say the same lesson. We do the same topic for 4 or 5 weeks before we move on. So this quarter, we learned about creation and Noah's Ark. And so we did little crafts like this chain link snake. And for Noah's Ark, we did a rainbow paper plate craft. And they were all picking out crafts for this week that they were going to show. But so I'm trying to do them a little bit of justice. But creation on the days. So that's kind of what I had to share. They really love Sabbath school. And it's amazing to see their imaginations at work, I would say, at this age. We have up to 5 kids in my class if everybody's there. They all would probably be too shy to come up here and talk except for Jada. So yeah, they're a really fun class, and I'm sure the young adults could agree because the walls are very thin down there. So.
All right, thank you guys. And then the next class is my class, and I have the junior early teens. And so we have done a variety of lessons, and then our big project I alluded to earlier, we chose one of our lessons, And we decided, and this was, I'm going to give Lena credit here. She said, she goes, why don't we make a YouTube channel? And I said, okay. And she kind of looked at me like she said, okay. And so we have worked really hard this quarter to make our very first YouTube channel video. And in a minute, Bobby will show that to you. And this is our little preview. And then after today, you'll be able to go on our Wadena SDA YouTube page. And there will also be a link where you can click on our kids' YouTube page. And we are aiming to add to that at least once a quarter. We'll select one of our lessons and share. And let me tell you guys, these kids have had a lot of fun with it. I've had fun with it. We've had a lot of help. And but also their heart is to reach their peers. And so I really, really appreciate that. It's hard because we're not all here every week. So sometimes our videos might not get to include everyone that we wish was there, but that's okay because they've done a lot behind the scenes too. Before we show that video, I do also want to share as a group, including Lauren's class and Sarah's class, we've also done a memory verse for the quarter that focuses on reaching our communities and encouraging our communities. And so if I could have my class, I guess, are the ones that are here today to share that verse with you. And it is actually, it's on one of our bulletin boards too, so you might have seen it up there before. But our memory verse for this quarter has been, encourage one another and build each other up, 1 Thessalonians 5:11. So that has been what we want to do as a group. We want to encourage one another, and we want to encourage our community. So with that, thank you guys, you can have a seat. With that, I will have Bobby show you, I think he can show you how to access our videos that we'll post.
I'll show the.
Okay.
Pretty simple, all you have to do is go to youtube.com and /@WSDA for kids. That's all you have to type, this right here. So that'll take you right to this. That'll be the video. The first video will post at 11 o'clock today. So just after we show this, the page will go live for everybody to see. So
sounds good. And they chose the name, that Seventh Day Family. I think that was Jonathan's idea. Because we are a family and we want to include and welcome others into our family. So we'll show our first video.
I'm Svea.
Hi, I'm Lena.
Hi, I'm Bella.
Hi, I'm Mackenzie.
Hi, I'm Jonathan.
And we are that Seventh Day Family.
Welcome to that Seventh Day Family.
We are excited to share Jesus' love with you.
Today's lesson teaches us that Jesus heals.
I would like to introduce you to Audrey and Maddie, two people who want to learn more about Jesus.
My grandma's really sick. I'm worried about her.
Why don't we pray for her?
Pray? I don't even believe in God. I can't see him.
You don't have to see him to know he's real.
I want to believe, but how can I know?
I know a Bible story that can help us with this.
I can't see. Can someone help me?
This happened to you so the works of God can be displayed.
What are they talking about?
This must be the story of Jesus healing the blind man that my pastor talked about.
Go and wash your eyes.
I can see you.
You see, miracles can happen. Jesus heals.
Let's pray for my grandma.
Speak light, speak light to the deadest, darkest night. Speak light, speak light when the sun will shine.
tongue gets twisted. Other days my thoughts just fall apart. I do, I don't, I will, I won't. It's like I'm drowning in the deep.
And thank you to Perry for being such a good sport. He filled in for Jonathan that day, and so we appreciate that. All right, so that is what we've been up to. And then with that, we are running low on time, so I'm going to hand the mic over to Scott, and he'll lead a little bit on, I know, what your adult class has been up to. I don't think we'll have time to show our mission video here as a group, but you can easily access that online as well. So, Scott, I will pass the mic to you.
Okay, so we have been looking at the book of Psalms for the adults, and let's see, I'm trying to think of what to say. There's not a lot of minutes left, so I want to just let's talk about this last week's Sabbath school lesson, and I want to go to a verse. If you have your Bibles handy this morning. Psalms 27:14, and that is actually the title of this last week's Sabbath school lesson, Psalms 27:14. And as some of you probably know, the title from this last week was Wait on the Lord. And so let's look at that this morning. Psalms 27, verse 14, and we're going to look at it very briefly, obviously. It says, wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. And what does that mean to us as Christians in 2024, to wait on the Lord? What are some thoughts that you guys have? What does this mean? What do you think? Wait on the Lord. Go ahead.
That's what I said.
It's hard to wait. I'm sorry. Okay, it's hard to wait. It's hard to wait, right?
To trust
in His time, His providence. To persevere, right? You know, we live in a world that's upside down, right? You don't know from one day to the next what's going to happen. There's tragedies all around us, and even that touch you personally, like Jimmy said this week, there's things that go on, and you never know from day to day, do we, just what is going to happen. And so we need to persevere, and we need to put our trust in the Lord. And I think it's so important that as Christians today, that prayer is such an important part of our Christian life, you know, each day, to be praying for one another, and for our church, and for this world, and for missions. There's so many things we should be on our knees about, and asking the Lord, because He is our strength. And so I just wanted to quickly make that point. That was kind of from the lesson this last week, but I see we are about out of time, and we'd like to take up a 13th Sabbath offering, I believe, at this time. And so this goes towards the mission projects that we talked about at the beginning of our service today. And so I think we'll have some plates coming up forward, and then what we'll do is we will close with a song also. So we'll take up our offering, then we'll have a song and a closing prayer is what we'll do, I think. That's...
Okay, so open your hymnals to hymn number 608, Faith is the Victory.
Close with prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning that we can come together to worship you, that we can learn about you even more, and we're so thankful for all the divisions, all the departments, our young people, and our old people, Father. We're thankful for each one that is here this morning. Please bless this church, we pray. Please be with us.